Loyal citizens, today our struggle ends. XCOM is no more.
Perfect.
The invasion was one thing. All their advanced technology. They had the drop on us for sure. But Advent, there's something we could never have prepared for. Even with better gear. Between the propaganda, the handouts, and a seemingly endless supply of reinforcing peacekeepers, they're nothing but trouble for an upstart resistance movement.
And hello again, welcome to another episode of XCOM 2 Season 3. I'm Falek, and a couple of things has happened in the last episode. First of all, we have finished working on psionics, which is very, very good. Now we're just waiting for the digging to be ready in our facilities so we can start building the psionics lab. Speaking of which, we have constructed the proving grounds. We do not yet have the facilities to build the schooljack because we don't have supplies. But we have started working on advanced ammunition and grenades, which is in general something we want to do because we want to have the incendiary bullets, we want to have blue screen bullets and stuff like that, and we also want to have the acid grenades, which is just fucking awesome and I can't live without it, and all that jeez. So, this is going to wait a little bit, and also we have completed the power relay, so now we can build up a little more, which is great because that means as soon as the dig is done we can start digging for that psionic lab. And next on the news, we have gotten additional contacts from scanning the random event on the map, which is great because it means that we don't have to build the resistance communications for a while yet, at least until we start expanding into another continent, and it also means that we could decide to use those resources somewhere else. And finally, we have made contact with a local gang that tell us that there is an Advent VIP on a PR tour, so we are going to get out there and punch him or her in the dick, or you know, or the vajayjay, whichever applicable. And once we do that, we are going to wipe the floor with aliens.
Capture the VIP alive. If all else fails, take him out.
And we have a new unassigned person. It's a grenadier for this mission. So if you want him, Vasily can be yours. Let me know in the comments. I run out of people to randomly assign to this character. Unless I mixed something up. Then in that case, remind me that you are still on the list and I will put you in his skin.
Target location confirmed. Move to engage. Eliminate all hostile contacts.
Squad concealment active.
Okay, we got the concealment. We have a shinobi with us, which we are going to use to deal with any ambushes that we can't avoid. Maybe without losing our concealment, that would be great. We have quite a long way to go. But I think we are gonna have to somehow make it. Basically, we have like 3 to 4 turns to get to that VIP. He is eating his Advent burgers, unsuspecting of anything, in the little diner over here. What he doesn't know yet is this meal will be his last. Sorry for the yawning, I'm recording since 7 a.m. today, because I want to have 2 or 3 episodes recorded today. Anyway, I'm going to speed up the footage.
Okay.
Carlo.
Alright, here we go. Basically, the plan is right now, I'm already set up for it. We are going to ambush the enemy. Unless the sniper can't... Fuck. Okay, never mind. We are going to reposition, then ambush the enemy.
Roger that.
I was going to steady my weapon. And I will. Okay. Okay, so yeah, I'm going to wait a turn, and then I'm going to tell you the plan.
Scanning.
Or maybe not. I guess I'm going to be using this opportunity to get closer to the enemy, because fuck them, that's why. They are bound to patrol back, and this is of course nice and well. However, it is only going to work for their demise.
Moving to designated position.
Scanning. Eyes on the prize. They keep moving away. Okay, so now I have a hard choice, because on one hand I want to simply keep going and, you know, get to the other side before they realize. But we are bound to meet more opposition that way. So that's not cool, obviously. I am at a loss at what to do. I think I'm going to tail them for one more turn and see what's gonna happen. Simply because I do not have a good decision to be made. I mean, I'm sure there is a good decision somewhere, I just don't know what it is.
Good copy, moving on target.
And thus, making it is going to be a little more difficult than I would have wanted. Though. Okay, if they start turning back, they will be in a perfect ambush position right now. I just don't want to have to fight them, carry the VIP, and fight other pods at the same time. Yeah, we got them in a better position now. Okay, so this is basically the plan. We are going to use a grenade to activate them all. And once they take any sort of cover, we are going to use the fact that we are very close to them to fuck them up. I'm going to also set a couple of overwatches, so it should all be nice and well. But who is not taking an overwatch? The sniper is not taking an overwatch. The specialist is going to be opening the fight. I mean, this. Actually, no. Specialist can actually overwatch. Okay. And Ru is going to be launching a frag grenade to start the fight. You need to stay covered, so. Yeah, I think Dr. Reich can overwatch. You can overwatch. Vas Andrew is gonna start the fight. And we kinda need the sniper and there should not be to be available to deal with anything that may be bad for us over there, and that way I think we should be able to take care of the whole pod at this turn. If not, we're fucked, so we better.
Menace 1-5, Firebrand is unable to approach the AO for evac. You're on your own out there. Regroup and try to buy us some time for an extraction. Take out those hostiles.
Okay, the most important have happened, the mutant is dead.
The mutant is dead.
So basically we have a sniper and a shinobi ready to deal with stuff. So let's start with the sniper fire. That pretty much covers the sniper fire. And allows me for a silent takedown, which means that for one turn enemy does not see the shinobi and allows me to get to him and stab him in the dick. Cheerio. That's a nice new visual effect, by the way. I haven't noticed that before. And thus we did not lose concealment, which is freaking important, right? Because now we can use the... Now we can use our scouting unit to actually scout ahead. And we have to evacuate in 7 turns, so we gotta hit the haste button.
Heading there now. Got a group of hostiles over here.
Yeah, yeah. We have our wrecker with some additional shebang happening. That's fine, I'm going to completely use this opportunity to get concealed Sean in position to open fire on them next turn, and we will be fine. Now I need to move so that we are far enough and not activate them. So that would be here.
Position confirmed.
Perfect.
That's affirmative.
Perfect.
Affirmative. Moving on.
That way they can't see our troopers and we can still ambush them. Having the opportunity to ambush the enemy pod twice in the same mission is basically as important as you can possibly imagine. Now let's hope they... Oh yeah, there we go! Nice, that is what I was hoping for and didn't even dare mention. Yeah, you're gonna get your donuts later. And now for taste of things to come. Booyah! Emphasis on fucking. And Sean got himself a promotion. And we still have our scout unit at hand.
Okay.
6 turns until dropship arrival. Even more targets inside. Alright. Do the same thing to them again then, because we can, we still not only can, we actually even have to. Let's stay as far away as we can. I think this will be good enough. Perfect, we can now shoot our target in the ding-dong if we need to. Let's put Suriel in a position of possible overwatch, should the enemy move our way.
Moving. Overwatch.
Alright.
Moving to overwatch.
We have 5 turns. I think opening up on the Viper might be the best idea. We can eliminate the trooper by tossing a knife. Actually, Stun Lancer is a better target. We are more likely to actually kill him. We don't have any overwatches because on that distance, that's just not gonna be good enough. Okay. Now, this is what we will do. We are getting in position, we are going to move on the middle of the field, toss the axe at the Advent Trooper, then run and gun and finish off the Stun Lancer if we actually can do both of those things at the same turn. And then we will focus fire on the Viper once we blow up her cover with a nade.
End of that location.
That's basically the extent of my plan. Shit.
Getting in close.
Obviously not cool, but what can you do? We're going to continue with the plan. At least some of it have worked. Alright, we will keep Shinobi for the laters. We are moving forward. Oh, we actually don't have a grenade. Well then. That's nice. And this will allow me to attempt, mind you, attempt a takedown. Nice, stealth preserved. We are raising the enemy suspicion level, but that shouldn't matter because the second knife should decide everything. Booyah! And we are at a higher suspicion level than previously. However, we are still concealed. That's the power of Shinobi with the Spec Ops mod. And yeah, we have no enemies to worry about. We can just get ready to grab our friend. I think I heard a mech. That's not good. Okay, we have 4 turns. We should be, mind the should, fully capable of getting shit done next turn. I'm just gonna send our scout to scout ahead. It doesn't seem to be anything threatening us now. So let's get close enough to actually be able to punch. We are, very good. Everybody else gets closer and reloads. Should we not activate additional foes?
Order's confirmed. Moving out. Moving to designated position.
You know what? I think the sniper can just catch up and reload next turn. I don't wanna keep Sean so far away from everybody. This is the dangerous part.
Advent reinforcements inbound.
All right. We'll take care of them.
Affirmative. Moving out.
We have 2 turns before we actually have to GTFO. So there is no reason to worry about it right now. Yeah, I'm going to have Sean pick up the sniper, the VIP. That's gonna be, I think, the best, and it's going to keep the boltcaster available for fire when necessary.
Moving. Affirmative. Covering now.
Yeah, I think we could.
Affirmative. Covering now.
On Overwatch.
Troops here.
Good luck. Aye.
Get it together.
Oh, that was horrible.
Get it together. I'm
spotted. That's what the Lancer gets for spotting our people. Oh.
Well-equipped mechanized combat unit. We'll need to look for vulnerabilities if we're going to take that thing out.
Oh, shit. Okay, so what we have to do is actually quite simple. We can evacuate soon. We are going to try and haywire protocol one of the mechs, because that's the only way we can possibly do it. It's the only way. We have to haywire protocol one of the mechs now. So, let's do it.
Going haywire.
You have to be mine. I can't look, that's just out. Oh yeah! Looks like the game has a good sense of what is appropriate. That gives us at least some time to deal with them. And that is everything I can possibly ask for, really. We have the Advent Heavy to be killed. And I think our Shinobi is going to have to do that. It was the only way. Now, we also have this guy that must die. He can, however, be killed with basically anybody. Sidewinder needs a chill. Frostbomb needs to go to take care of the other mech. And we also have Dr. Reich, who needs to drop down the enemy on his dick. So basically this is what we have to do. We have to pistol the Advent Warden to hell without a flank, that's the important part. We are going to have to then utilize the frost bomb to stall the Advent mech. We will have to let the Sidewinder do whatever the hell. Actually, no, we will have to frostbomb the Sidewinder and let the mech do whatever the mech wants to do. And we have to pistol slap the Warden. So, I'm gonna do that. I don't like it, but what can you do? No fucking way! Ugh. I don't think it changes anything though. sadly it doesn't change.
Move into designated position.
We are going to suffer, but you know, we're gonna suffer. Okay. Now the only question is, what do I want to happen? What is worse? Have the Sidewinder do whatever it wants to do. It's not gonna be pretty. Count on the mech to attack the other mech and not go for our people. Or hope that the Advent Warden is gonna do something really stupid and dumb. Which is gonna be the worst for us. But yeah, we don't have a choice. We have to take care of the Warden. That was a really seriously bad combination of reinforcements and patrol walking into us at the same time. Really bad. And those missed overwatches, that was just that basically buried us. That's all I have to say. Too bad, we are evacuating in 2 turns, so it's fine. Okay, we have to now drop down the...
That didn't feel good.
Yeah, well, what can you do?
This looks a little ugly.
I feel kind of weak.
Yeah, well, what can you do? Oh, what can you do when the game speeds on you? Right, so yeah, basically we can have the mechs get busy with each other. Unfortunately we are incapable of getting rid of anything. We are going to have to get out next turn, so basically this is the only way. I don't like it any more than you do.
Order's confirmed. On the move.
Shit. Well, okay. We are going to freeze the Sidewinder then. Where is it?
Catch!
That was almost flawless, wasn't it? It's just a serious case of bad luck. And also dare I say that our hearts were not open at all. At all. And yeah, if we manage to kill the Sidewinder now, we can at least get the loot. I could have thought about it before using the frost bomb, but I didn't, so I'm just gonna have to live with it.
Looks like something over here.
Nice, more lock boxes.
Got something good here.
I don't yet know what is in them, but you know. Okay, that gives us some undetermined amount of time. Oh yeah, you are also under effect of acid. Okay, so yeah, hopefully we can actually get it done next turn. Because if not, then obviously we lost. Oh no, the mech is going somewhere else. No, it's not. Good job, good job. Good on you.
Ah!
Nobody panics. Nobody panic. Nobody fucking panic. There we go.
It's likely the enemy will keep sending reinforcements. We should get our people out of there.
Okay, so it is time to evacuate. We have nothing else that can be done. Our timer is gone.
Target package in custody.
Let's see how far we can get.
You're with us, one way or another.
We can theoretically get over here, but is everybody else going to be able to catch up? I don't see it, unless we have a frag grenade. Which we don't. Yeah, I don't think we will be able to evacuate from here because of the tilted rooftop, so that place is bust. I doubt this is going to be good. We could get out from this position, but this is only one position that we could do this from. And it would mean that the whole team would have to run. So, but yeah, I doubt this is going to be helpful, or happening for that matter. I will consider options. Oh, bloody hell. Well, yeah, this is the only choice we really have, so... Come on, Zuriel. I fucking knew it, see? Well, let's see if we can get out next turn, shall we? We will, of course, have to deal with both the mechs to actually be able to earn anything. But we don't have anything better to do. It's not like we are leaving this turn, so... You know, fuck it. If anybody panics, I will literally tear them to shreds. We will lose our mech soon, so... You are still under. Okay, just in case Vasiliev panics, I'm going to put him over here.
10-4.
He's acided, so we can't really make any assumptions about that. And we have a run and gun available here. Too bad it doesn't show me if I will actually be able to evacuate, but screw it, there is no other choice. I hate not having choices. No!
Get it together!
You are pissing me off. Well, let's just evac Vasiliev and spare him some wounds then. We are leaving next turn regardless of what's going to happen. Oh, you're still hacked. Oh, I love you. I know. Don't panic though. Don't panic. Don't you fucking dare.
Looks like they called in some friends.
That's all right. Can we still evacuate?
That's affirmative.
It seems like we can, yes, that's great. It seems that we actually can. Come on, Zuriel, let's GTFO. Okay, that was a little scary for a second there, wasn't it? We are one turn behind schedule and the enemy is calling in reinforcements. So it's gonna be very, very good to not have to worry about it. We have lost the hack effect, but it's okay. Because we're getting the shit out of here. Lo and behold. We can't actually fire on the mech anymore, but I think that at this point we don't really care.
I'm gone.
Alright, we're gone.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
And we have taken a lot of wounds. We were attacked literally once, but it has costed us three wounded soldiers, all because of problems. See, we are wounded for 2 weeks or so because of that one little acid attack that we simply had to put up with. We could have avoided it and it would be a flawless mission if not for that shitty, really screwy luck with the reinforcements that just missed up at a very close range. And then we didn't have the firepower to eliminate enemies in time. But hey, all in all, it could be much worse and at least everybody got a promotion. So yeah, let's see, what do we have? We have Sean. Sean is a sniper. I'm going to be taking him as a snapshot. He's going to be like this middle range, something in between long range and a pistol sniper. We will see how that works. Snapshot will of course allow him to move after shooting, but he no longer has the good range bonuses. Now, Dr. Reich, this is a little bit of a tricky situation. We can take a close combat specialist, which means that he's works exactly like the long war one. Get a free shot on everybody who moves or tries to fire close enough. And up close and close and personal is giving us additional crit chance against targets that are next to us, so that's basically more crit with the melee weapon. Because as close as we are, the better it is. And formidable basically makes our assault a little more tanky, but since we are not using any armor mods because there aren't any good ones currently available, unfortunately, then tanking is still kind of pointless. We must rather focus on misdirection instead. So the formidable is not going to be of any use for us. However, close combat specialist is going to be great, because that way we can still attack in melee, and if the target survives and tries to run away or shoot us, he gets shot in the dick, so that's pretty perfect. Now, Zuriel is getting combat protocol. We are getting by the template, so that's how it's going to be. Now, Phantom is getting shadow strike, because fuck yeah, that's why. I think Phantom is a much better name of the class than Shinobi. I don't even know what Shinobi is, so you know, other than this class. So it obviously doesn't work. Nice for me. And we get Heavy Ordnance for Andrei Vasilev, or whoever he's going to be. It's up to you, let me know in the comments if you want to be him. And we got the little blonde Advent Collaborator, three more log boxes, and all the good stuff. So all in all, I think he's pretty fine. And we got now the supplies we require to build the Psylab, which is, and the mimic beacons right after the abduction, autopsy is complete. So this is pretty important. We also counter the rapid response dark event, which is obviously quite nice as well. And it's an additional guerrilla ops that we wouldn't normally have, so that's great. In any case, thank you guys for watching, I hope you enjoyed this video. If so, let me know in the comments, like it, follow me on Facebook and Twitter and so on and so forth, and I will be seeing you again in the next one. For now, I will be seeing you again. See you later, guys.